Topping our headlines also today, a suicide contagion is what some experts are calling this, and saying that it's gripped one Northeast Ohio community.
Six teenagers have taken their own lives in the past 6 months.
A subject that didn't usually make news headlines, fearing it would encourage others. Sadly, now teen suicide has been gripping the headlines and becoming almost routine discussion.
We need to make a difference. We need to make sure that these losses are not in vain.
According to the Centers for Disease Control, more students in Cleveland have attempted suicide than in any other city in our nation. In fact, 20%, or 1 in 5 students, have attempted suicide, a rate that is almost then double in districts like Boston, New York City, and LA. And the numbers in Ohio have more than tripled in just 3 years. And if that's not a big enough shock, suicide rates for children ages 10 to 14 have increased 136% since 2010.
We have stories from first grade teachers, one here locally, that in her classroom, she has had one suicide attempt and she's got 4 girls who are already cutting in first grade.
Jack Binder is the CEO of LifeACT, a suicide prevention program in schools. He told me 4 out of 5 teens who attempted suicide give clear warning signs. But why aren't we listening?
Administrators, parents, coaches, ministers, let's just say the next generation above, will say, we never saw this coming. There were no signs, there were no indications. And from their perspective, they're right. Either because there were none expressed to them or they didn't know what to look for. From the perspective of the peers, you ask them and they shake their head and they say, who didn't see this coming? All the signs were there, we didn't know what to do with them.
Experts say the number one cause of suicide, depression, especially if that depression is untreated or undiagnosed.
It really is an epidemic that is, it's the number one cause of death from the ages of 0 to 34 years old after accidents. And of the top 10 causes of death in that age range, 9 of them are on the decline. Year after year after year, they're all going down. Suicide is going up year after year after year. And we just don't seem to acknowledge that this is possibly our biggest epidemic right now.
Obviously, no area is immune to teen suicide, but the area here in Starr County, Perry Local Schools, has been hit especially hard with these suicides in the last recent months.
She was awesome. She was fun, funny, full of life, loving, caring, loved her little brothers, loved taking pictures, just typical teenager, you know, happy with all.
Just a few months ago, on October 31st, Jonathan Forney's 16-year-old daughter, Kylie, took her life.
We went trick-or-treating. She was upset about a breakup. I actually took her to collect some of her final things from the boys' house. She was crying and a little bit upset, but you know, the crying had stopped and we'd talked. And
Stacy called me. She walked in the door and said she hung herself.
2 students at Perry had already taken their lives from the start of the school year. Kylie would be the 3rd.
There's a word that's been come up, a contagion. It's in your face. It's something you see. It's very easy to, I guess, just jump on the bandwagon almost. Like it's becoming cool.
It's crazy.
Kylie's mom, Stacy Crawford, told me both parents were very active in trying to help Kylie. They were working with treatment centers, doctors, and the school, especially since Kylie had attempted suicide before. But in the end, she says it wasn't enough.
The most active feeling. It's changed me. I don't even feel like the same person. I think a lot of me left when she left. There's not like a second, a day that I don't think like, literally consumes my mind.
Since Kylie's suicide, three more current or former students at Perry Local Schools have taken their lives.
I don't know what these young people are thinking. Like I said, some of it could be just, it's an easier way out. The more you hear about it, you know, the more you read about it, then it becomes more of a thought process. When I was a kid, you know, I thought about it and then it was gone and it wasn't put in my face. These kids are going to school and there's empty desks.
Scott Beatty is the superintendent of Perry Local Schools. He says these last few months have been simply overwhelming for the students, staff, and teachers.
The fact that focus on test scores and state proficiency and ACT is we're at the bottom level. We're at Maslow's hierarchy here in Perry Local. We need to meet the basic needs of our young people before we can go any further.
The school has brought in special crisis counselors, programs, and behavioral health specialists. The community is trying to come together with prayer services and community rallies, all in the hope of making every single child feel loved and special and needed.
If you think this world, where you're at, is a dead end, that's a lie. Because there is hope. What we need to do is use these struggles that we're going for and opportunities like this to just demand that we make this a better world, that there is hope.
Meantime, this grieving mother is starting her personal journey of hope and healing.
I want to get to the point someday where when I think about her, when I see her, it's not so much sadness. When I think about